On this week's Throwdown, we have Moist Mike and Juicy Jordan demoing the workout.
What?
Yes.
Sorry, Mike.
We've got wall balls, chest bars, hang power cleans, and push press.
We release these workouts right here on YouTube every Thursday at 1 p.m.
Oh. Best one yet. Join our entire community to practice the skill of competing.
Use the next 2 days to plan a strategy, grab some friends, and throw down on Saturday.
See where you stack up each week on our Throwdown leaderboard. It's free to sign up. Go to trainingthinktank.com/throwdown. This week's workout is a little bit of a different style. The idea was given to me by one of our remote clients, Hyung. He is the unsexy stuff on Instagram. Mia, tell us all about it.
So we have a 12-minute AMRAP of 4 different movements, and there's no rep scheme. Starts with wall balls, chest to bar, hang power cleans, and then push press. You can do as many or as little reps on each movement as you want, with the goal of getting as many, the most total reps within 12 minutes as you can. So you have to start with wall balls, and you have to go in order of those 4 movements, and the reps have to be unbroken. So if you do 10 wall balls and you drop it, you can't pick it back up and do 4 more. You have to move on to the chest bars. You can rest 1 second, you can rest 2 minutes, and do as big or as small of a set as you want, and just keep rotating through those 4 movements for 12 minutes.
2 standards of note for the push press. It is a true push press. You cannot do shoulder overhead, and on the hang power cleans, make sure your elbows pass the bar at the top of each rep.
We got 2 demo athletes this week. We got Big Bully Mike and Jordan. Jordan's a little bit smaller of an athlete in CrossFit, so he is gonna try to capitalize on gymnastics. Mike is gonna try to move the bar like the gorilla he is.
We have a camp coming up.
Tell us about it, Mia.
December 5th, right? December 5th, training camp on site. It's almost full, not quite full, so if you wanna come hang out with us, check it out on our website.
TrainingThinkTank.com/camps.
Let's go see these guys' strategies.
Hey, strategy is take advantage of the movements I'm good at, things like hang power cleans and wall ball. So do bigger sets there just when I feel really good. And then the other movements like the push press I feel like are a little more taxing and the chest to bar a little more taxing. Just kind of like go until I lose speed and then just move on. So I think it's going to be a very like by feel movement. I think going into it with a set rep scheme just isn't going to work for me. So go by feel and then just like let the reps kind of dwindle down in terms of how big the sets are as the workout goes on and just focus on keeping transitions fast. Any other questions? None?
Nope.
Ask me.
No.
Ask me.
No.
Ask me.
What's the station play?
WNBC.
Strategy, sir.
Right after intervals. I'm gonna open a little bit
a bigger. A can of whoop ass? Atta boy?
Yeah. I'm gonna open a little
Don't
bit
Don't leave
larger.
Me hanging.
Huh?
Rude.
A little bit larger. Maybe like AMRAP -3. And then I'm gonna kind of settle in. Maybe hold like an AMRAP -3 or -4 the whole time. And yeah, try and bank on the chest bars early. And then later on, do more wall balls, more barbell.
And what's the station that plays all the hits?
I'm glad you asked, Chris. Here in Atlanta, it was 99X. 99X went away. Project 961 merged with 99X.
All right, 99X. That's all the
time we got. That was the best intro ever.
That was very enjoyable.
Oh, man. Mike was waiting for it the entire time, too. How did he know that was going to be asked? Max.
You just start watching the videos.
Also, I could just hear Liam screaming in the background the entire time.
Dad!
That's what he's trying to say.
Not yet.
Wow, this is a very long delay here.
Yeah, Chris. Amateur move there.
Unreal.
Oh, we're getting close.
Adam looks so much more serious than you, Mia.
We're getting close.
Really? I think that's just the
beard. And we're going. All right, so let's watch Mike. His strategy was
said
open
big,
with a
big
really
big
set of wall balls.
AKA 10.
I like that he's accountable to his strategies.
So there obviously are a ton of ways. I love this workout. It's like the first time we've ever done something where basically you can strategize it however you'd like based on the skills or limitations that you may have. There are a ton of ways you can do it.
how would you guys, what movement would you guys attack, or would you just kind of go small sets the entire time?
I think I would try to capitalize on push presses. I think that's the least taxing movement for me out of this, and fastest cycle rate, which would mean I could take advantage of it and utilize rest time.
Yeah. So Jordan is busting out a set of 35 chest bar pull-ups here, which is the biggest set of anything that anyone does in the workout.
Yeah.
So just to note that that was his strategy to start. And after this workout, he told me that he would have started with 50 if he did it again.
Whoa, all right.
And Mike did 10 wall balls and then 15 hang power cleans, which is a big set of hang power cleans. And if you guys were watching Mike there, he's super fast. So I would say the average based on the data we have is probably like 1.25 seconds per rep for an elite male. Mike's almost like a second a rep for hang power clean. So that does make sense for someone like him.
Yeah.
But if you watch Jordan here, it's fast, but that's a little bit slower and he has to dip underneath it.
Yeah, the other thing to note is that Mike went, he was already back to his wall ball set and it was basically a minute of total time elapsed out of the whole AMRAP. So his strategy in approaching it is basically go from movement to movement to movement, moving really quickly and staying under his threshold and transitioning really quickly. That obviously is not going to sustain over the course of a whole workout. And if you add up the total number of reps by the time we get finished, this workout kind of comes out to like 1-to-1 work to rest ratio. So you do have time within there to rest or transition and try to take advantage of different types of sets, or maybe a big set on one movement and a little set. Me actually had the idea beforehand, which I'm going to steal now because it was smart. Do a big set in one round, then a small set in the next round, and then a big set in the next round, which basically spreads the amount of time out between that same movement.
The way you said that, they have no idea what you just said.
Yeah, so maybe it's like...
Say it again then.
So basically, every four rounds, I would prioritize one movement and try to hit a big set of that. So a big set of chest to bar is what I would start with. Obviously, I have to do a couple wall balls before doing that, and then do just a small set of everything else, rotate back, hit a small set of chest to bar, hit a big set of hang power clean, small set, rotate back, bigger set of push press, small set, everything else, rotate back. So every four rounds, you're doing a big set of something. That might not work. I don't know, but it just seems like it. Yeah. It could be a good strategy.
I was thinking, or maybe I misunderstood you when you first told me.
So my strategy is not smart.
I like the concept, but if I, for example, wanted to take advantage of push press, I might do a big set of push press in one of the rounds going through the four movements. Then the next time when push press comes up, I might just do a quick one to spread it out so that when I get back to the push press in the third consecutive round of it, I can go big on alternate sets. So that way there's more time between those bigger sets. Because one big set is going to redline me.
I am going to nerd out a little bit. I have a three-step process here for the way that I look at this workout. The first one is, how long does each movement take per rep? So the fastest reps for me would be the chest to bar. I'm about 1 second per rep or just under that. And then the push press, which is also about 1 second per rep. Wall balls take me 1.85 to 1.9. And I know that's weird, but I time myself on all these things. And then the hang power clean, I'm pretty slow because I can't do the bop bop like maybe Mike or Jordan. So that's also slow for me. So the way I'd look at it first is I want to attack the chest to bars and the push press early on and get as many reps done as possible because those will take the fewest amount of time to get, let's say 40 or 50
a
reps.
A big set in the least amount of time.
For sure. The second thing is, how can I minimize my transition? So then that's kind of closer to what Mia's talking about, where maybe it is I do a big set and then smaller sets to really transition quickly, because total rest time still is kind of what matters in a workout like this. They rested almost 5.5 to 6 minutes total. I know it doesn't look like it, but with all the transitions, it's just a lot of time that's kind of elapsing while they're standing around. Like you can see
Mike
both
right
of them
here,
right
just
now.
Yeah. Chilling.
And then the last thing is, which movements are going to fatigue me most, because I need to protect myself from redlining if I do big sets later on in the workout. And for me, that's hang power cleans, right? So I'm thinking maybe I would go 5 wall ball, 20 chest to bar, 5 hang power clean, 20 push press for 3 or 4 straight rounds, because I know I have the endurance on the chest to bars and the push press to do that. And now I'm already at 150 plus reps in the workout in maybe 4 or 5 minutes.
So you think an athlete, so let's say Mike and Jordan here rested 5.5 minutes in this workout. If this were executed and people were working more and resting less, what is the minimum amount of rest time that's just going to happen as a result of transitions and just like normal amounts of fitness? Will an elite athlete just be going through this cycle continuously doing, 10 wall balls, 10 chest of bars, 5 and 5, and just keep moving as the whole time.
Yeah, I mean, someone like a Noah, Frazier, Travis, they probably could do that and then have rest time around 3.5 to 4 minutes, but I still think it's gonna be that long just because you have to move around to the, and every movement has to be unbroken.
Yeah.
So that's one of the things. Originally, we wrote this and said, you can break it up however you want, but I really like putting the standard where each movement must be unbroken, because then you go to the next one and you are a little bit more fatigued, you can't pace it that way.
Yeah.
So to pick at them a little bit, which, I mean, this is a tough workout to do as, it reminds me of, what was it, 20.5, when we had to do it on Thursday night, and I was like, I have no idea, and in the demo, I was just doing what Ryan was telling me to do and not thinking at all.
So but, basically, they're the two sacrificial lambs.
For sure. But there were a lot of times where they would take longer transitions and get to the bar or get to the chest bar and do, like, 1 to 3 reps. And I just thought that that was kind of a, like, a big waste of time. If you know that you're gonna only do, I'd say, 4 or less reps on a movement, just get them done quickly, like make that transition, hit that. And then if you're, you know, if your plan is to get back and do a bigger set of wall balls and take your rest then, because they would take the rest before that 1 to 3 reps and then again before the bigger set. And that's probably where a lot of time was lost. But they probably didn't actually know what they were going to do for their next sets, because I bet if they both redid this, they would probably do a lot better having felt it and knowing what it's like.
One thing I really like about this workout, like Jordan would be a gymnastics specialist in the sport, so a workout like this, he sees, and from an overall rep standpoint, just starting with 35 puts him way ahead on that movement relative to other movements. So you know, like, all right, well, you could take a lot of advantage of having this movement in here. But if somebody was really bad at chest to bars, they could have a different movement in here and a completely different strategy. So I think this one, we started to see in 20.5, people kind of converge to similar types of strategies.
Yeah.
But in a workout like this with 4 different movements that you have to go unbroken, I think that individual strategy is going to be super important here. And it's about figuring out, do you want to do small sets of everything and try to treat it like a continuous AMRAP? Do you want to try to go really big on 1 or 2 movements throughout and space those out with appropriate rest times? Do you want to do something like Mia said, go really big on 1 movement every single time you go through the rotation and change that movement? And I think it's going to be kind of a process of trial and error, and us also seeing the data. We're not really experts in analyzing workouts like this, because this is the first time we're doing it and testing it on a broad scale. So I think it's really cool, and also probably plays into what this sport is all about, is just figuring out, here's a fitness test, solve the equation and get the most that you can.
This would be one, if it was in the open, that people would have to retest 3 or maybe even 4 times to really figure out, maybe even stop halfway through and say, that's not good. 5, 6, 7, 24. They would probably stop halfway through and say, this is not the strategy for me, and then restart later on in the day. It would be a blast to see this though.
Yeah,
and this is not a critique on them, because when you're a demo, you have to set up the way the camera needs you to set up, but putting that barbell like right next to that pull-up bar and just having a little triangle to rotate, I think is also really smart.
Yeah, I agree. That's actually one of the things, Max, when you asked that question about what would total rest time be for an elite, that would change the game. They would have their barbell like right underneath the pull-up bar, and that almost would be like 20.2, where it was that 20-minute AMRAP where people were just basically flying through, kind of like a triangle setup like Mia said.
Based on this past transition of Mike going from the barbell and then going and hunching over the wall ball for 10 or 15 seconds, I'm not sure that was a differentiator. But I do understand your point.
Mike, he's hating on you.
Not only will Mike see this in the video, but he's actually over there in the room and can hear me talking badly about him.
Yeah,
and he still loves me.
You're a bully. So something I thought was interesting, Jordan, who is a shorter athlete and not a wall ball fan, settled into bigger sets of wall balls than other movements on the back half of this workout. So I thought that was interesting. It is like the least power output movement, I would, for me at least, but it also takes the longest. So it's kind of like, what do you choose?
And that's normal in the sport, right? The movements that take the longest are usually the easiest, quote, unquote, easiest to do. But they, again, also take the longest. So it's almost double the amount of time maybe a chest bar or a push press would take. So you got to think about it that way.
Yeah, I think so. Jordan just jumped up. I think he did either two or three chest bars. And I guess this is a little bit of a criticism, but I think he would have been way better off after a small set of wall balls, just chilling there for 30 seconds and being able to hit a set of 15 or 20 on the chest to bars, because doing the small sets with kind of moderate to slow transitions, I just don't think really pans out in overall scoring.
Yeah, I will say though, he still did 112 chest to bars in the workout.
So oh, he did. Based on the start.
There was quite a bit of volume there as compared to Mike, who basically did half, 64 chest to bars.
So where did Mike? What was Mike's highest total movement?
So Mike spent a lot of, he was much more kind of evenly dispersed throughout, but he did wall balls at 85, 64 chest to bars, 83 hang power cleans, and then 51 push press. I know Mike said he doesn't like push press. We talked about this before, but that's something that I would assume Mike would have attacked a little bit more and maybe made 100 of those or 105 of those and then evenly dispersed the rest of those.
What was Jordan's hang power cleans compared to Mike? Because they were
so he did 29 hang power cleans. Yeah.
So Jordan did 103 wall balls, 112 chest to bars, and then 29 hang power clean and 35 push press. So way less total work on the barbell, but a lot more distributed work on chest to bars. So he got closer, and they were actually really close on this overall. By leveraging his capacity in chest to bars.
So they have 30 seconds left. He did a pretty good job transitioning here, but if you're gonna hit 1-1, it just has to be, I think that's what it should have been like throughout the workout, and that would have saved a ton of time.
I think finishing kick, like at some point, maybe when you're somewhere around a minute, you gotta realize where you are, get yourself back to your fastest cycling movement that you think you can hit the biggest set of, and then just go to failure right to the buzzer.
Which was what they're both doing.
Yeah, so
they both do a pretty good job the last 10 seconds of this.
So what were the total reps comparison here?
So Mike at 282 and Jordan at 279.
Really so close.
Tight. They really knew where each other were at because you guys were counting total reps, but
that's
one of
true.
The things that I'm going to have on site when everyone else does this, they're going to do it where they only count the movement that they're on, so no one knows where each other are at.
I really like that.
Everyone's going to mess up that math, but all right.
Project Pat, you know the deal.
It's a wrap, you know what I'm saying? Your boy Project Patar and his thing. Man. Hey, look, man, thank y'all for watching Training Think Tank's YouTube channel. Y'all hit that motherfucking subscribe button, you know what I'm saying? So y'all go ahead, man. Thank y'all for watching the channel, you know what I'm saying? Hit that motherfucking subscribe button. Let it be known what it be known, what it be known, you know what I'm saying? Hot talk.